Okay. So ready for last session?
Yes.
Water treatment plant. We spoke a lot about sewage treatment plant. So what was our basic intention in the sewage? To remove the impurities, pollutants, whatever come from the soil and waste. Now we will talk about the water treatment plant. Quickly tell me why water need to be treated. Anybody?
To make it potable.
Make it potable. Make it drinkable. So basic properties of water, density is 1000 kg per meter cube, boiling point 100 degree centigrade, and formula, chemical formula, H2. What are the water sources? We all know they are water sources. River, groundwater, alternative sources as storm water, desalination, decentralized sources. There could be many sources. What is the latest source? Can anybody tell me? Yes? That is there since thousands of years. What is the latest source? Dehumidifiers. So most of the desert, they are experimenting dehumidifiers and they are trying to get the water. It is exactly reverse process of air conditioning, but still wherever there is a very scarcity or difficult to transport the water, dehumidifiers are helping a lot. Worldwide standard, WHO guidelines are there, European drinking water directives are there, US EPA is there, and IST is there. 10,500 you have to make by heart. This is the ice code you will be, you have to tell anyone and everyone. What is EPA? US EPA? What is US EPA? Full form, quickly. United States Environmental Protection Agency. Very, very dominating agency over there, which sets many standards. So, defining water as per IS 10500, drinking water is a water intended for human consumption. Okay, and drinking water shall comply with the requirements given in the tables 1 to 4. So, as I said earlier, that what makes the water drinkable, if the water is complying to these acceptable limits, okay, and remarks, then it may, the water is drinkable. So, what are the parameters? Color, odor, pH, TSS, turbidity, aluminium, magnesium, boron, calcium, phosphates, copper, fluorides, n number of things. They are covered in all these slides. Some are acceptable. No relaxation. So sulfates, if more than 0.05, not acceptable. Sometimes the limit is given. Total alkalinity has to be between 200 to 600. But sometimes no relaxation is given, because it has a very ill effect on our health. So these tables you guys can see later on. They are already there in the IS 10500 or also available in this PPT. Drinking water quality standards. So what we will do, there are these few slides are there which will tell you what are the parameters and what is their acceptable limit, what is risk if the parameter is increased or decreased, what is the source of this impurity or pollutant, and what should be the treatment. Okay, so color, will you drink the water which has color? When I go to Dubai, the South Indian restaurants serve the water with pink tinted color. Pite na? But that water initially is colorless. We know purposefully the color is added, correct? So if you go anywhere where you don't know the thing, will you drink the water with color? No. If the water is smelling, will you drink it?
No.
Most of the times in the restaurants, in the egg, is prepared in the glasses, you will smell that. We get a very bad feeling about it. We don't want to drink it. So color shouldn't be there. If color is there, what are the sources? Iron, copper, manganese basically. And then treatment, filtration, desalination, distillation, reverse osmosis and ozonization. Focus on reverse osmosis. You are hardly going to require to know about this distillation and ozonization. Reverse osmosis is a exactly process like MBR. Few hours back we learnt about MBR. What was it? Filtration. So RO is nothing but the filtration. A very very fine filter which removes all the unwanted bacteria. The pores are designed in such a way it removes all the unwanted bacteria and make the water drinkable. Nowadays there is a publication from WHO that don't drink the RO water so frequently. Try to add with some normal water also, because your immunity gets damaged if you seriously drink so much of RO water. But here we are talking about removal of this color pollutant and how it can be removed with this process. Odor, see, rotten egg, musty chemical, this causes odor, risk of, and treatment, air stripping, oxidation, activated carbon, and activated carbon is much much popular process for odor removal. pH, quickly can anybody tell me if pH is less than 6.5, is it acidic or alkaline? Alkaline. Sorry? Yes? It is acidic. It's okay. I also get confused sometimes. So it is acidic. We shouldn't be drinking acidic or alkaline water. Okay. It has to be neutral. Then what are the treatments? If either water is acidic, add some alkalinity. If water is alkaline, add some acidity. Simple. Taste, it should have agreeable taste. If I drink it, I feel okay. Sometimes if you drink your distillery water quickly by opening it, you will feel like it is giving a good, nice feeling. There is a taste. Why the taste is there? Because they add some oxygen to it. And when you open it and sip it, first few sips you will feel nice. They made it purposeful. So taste is subjective. If you feel like, yeah, I am okay with it, you can have that. But if you feel like some risk, you can you should avoid drinking such water. Bad taste is indicator of contamination, hence test and water, test the water and treat accordingly. Turbidity, what is turbidity? If you take the water in a glass, you can see some impurities, it is turbid. Turbidity can be because of two things. One is TSS, total suspended solid, or because of dissolved solids. Dissolved solid also causes turbidity. So this is the risk and effect. Sources of turbidity can be anything. Treated, ultrafiltration and reverse osmosis. UF, we call it popularly UF. So these are the different standards. Their acceptable limit, permissible limits, risk or effects, sources and treatment. So TDS, what is dissolved solid? Suspended and dissolved. Two things are there. So I will quickly clarify. Dissolved is salt is gets dissolved. What we say, salt is not suspended. Salt is dissolved. You mix it and it vanishes. So it is dissolved. The only criteria or the only treatment to remove the dissolved solid is reverse osmosis. There could be something, but the popular one is reverse osmosis. Hardness, what is CaCO3? Calcium carbonate. Okay. So hardness can be treated with softener, ion exchange and reverse osmosis. Water softening karo with ion exchange technique and you will get the soft water. Alkalinity. So these are the parameters, and as we were discussing, I was explaining like their risks, sources and treatments. I'll move fast little bit. Cyanide, no relaxation. Can you have relaxation?
No.
Has anybody tested? Here we are saying pesticide, no relaxation. But every day we take lot of pesticide through different means. So here I want to focus little bit more in this presentation. The basic type of water treatment. There are classes of water A, B, C, D. So class A, good quality, good source water. Rain is a good source water. You might not need the treatment. But nowadays because of pollution, authority says it mixed with the CO, it forms H2SO4 or acids, so don't drink it directly. So class A category water does not need treatment, class B only disinfection, class C standard water treatment like basic filtration and all, and class D special, which is like RO or something. So the categorization of water treatments are depend upon source of water. Pre-treatment, post-screening, fine-screening, equalization, naturalization, chemical pre-treatment, primary treatment, coagulation. What is coagulation? Gathering the suspended impurities and making them heavy so that they become settleable. This is called as coagulation. There are coagulants available which are added in the water. So we know the very famous coagulant, which is that secondary treatment is filtration, disinfection, advanced treatment, absorption, iron manganese removal, fluoridation. So water treatment categories. Treatment category, pre-treatment, what could be core screen, bar screen, removal, filtration, primary treatment, coagulation and mixing, flocculation. What is flock? झाग, सोप के साथ जिसने से जो झाग बनते हैं, फ्लॉकुलेशन. फ्लॉकुलेशन से क्या होगा? The flock जैसा जैसा जनरेट होगा, it will जो सस्पेंडेड पार्टिकल्स है, it will help the making them talk. Disinfections, so various disinfections. Popular disinfection is and chlorine is popular disinfection. Advanced treatment, adsorption, activated carbon, membrane process, effluent, manganese removal. So this is advanced. Distribution network, yes. So you need to add some disinfection in the distribution network as also. Selection of treatment process. How we will select the treatment process? If we are taking the water from the river and immediately after source starting of the river where no pollutants are added, no city sewage is added, we can just have basic filtration and we can use that water. We can add some chlorine so that whatever bacteria get inside while the distribution network, it will get killed. But that's it. So we spoke about coagulation, flocculation, sedimentation. What could be sedimentation? Allow the water to halt for a while and then it will, the solid particles will get settled. That's it, sedimentation. Filtration, removing the suspended and settled particles. Disinfection. So chlorine is used because it is very effective disinfection, and residual chlorine can be maintained guard against possible biological contamination. Sludge dry, fluoridization. So fluoridization, because of fluoridization, your teeth may get pale yellow tints. So fluorides has to be removed. pH correction. So as I said, if alkalinity is more, add acidic. Acidity is more, add alkalinity. Basic water treatment plant process. raw water collection, filter feed pump, activated carbon filter, softener, if it hardness is there, then dosing tank, chlorine dosing pump and treated water. Simple. Like we saw so many processes, SAF, FAB, extended aeration, ASP in the sewage treatment. Like that, there are no so many processes in the water treatment. Water treatment is quite straightforward. So softening cycle is there, service cycle is there, brine tank which adds the brine solution which makes the water soft. So most of the things which we discussed so far were for the building level filtration unit. But when city level treatments are there, the treatments are little different. So raw water collected, coagulation is added, sedimentation is allowed, then carbon, sand and gravel filter is there, pH correction is happened, anti-corrosion agents are added, fluorination is done and then it is distributed in the network so that you can get the water. So the process is little different for the, and if you have a chance to see the city level water treatment plants, they are very beautiful. There are trickling filters, there are cascades, there are so many nice things. You can see the scale of that plant. There are literally wells where the water is stored, coagulants are added and then flock is generated, flock removals are there. They are like slurry flocculators. So flock is removed, sedimentation is removed. So very beautiful place to see. So these are the different processes for the different sources. Like this is for the reservoir to home, this is for the river to home. So river water is that one pristine. River water does not require much filtration or much treatment. So that's why chemical mixing, flocculation basins, as I said, clary flocculators, sedimentation, adding ammonia, chloride, disinfections, then treated water storage and sending it to reservoirs, ESR or GSR, elevated service reservoirs or ground service reservoir, then distribution networks. So similarly, some tweaking the process for the lake water. So river water, lake water will have high concentration of solids because they flow naturally. Wells. Now wells will not have much suspended solid, but wells will have dissolved solid. So you need to define the process according to removal of dissolved solids. Rainwater. As we said, rain is a good quality, but yes, we have polluted the weather, so in metro cities at least we don't get a good quality rain. But considering theoretically we are getting a good rain, we can reservoir, screening, gravity filters, then possible other chemical treatment, temporary storage, purified water and distribution. Rainwater is very dangerous to drink directly because we are habituated to drink the water which contains minerals. Absolutely. Rainwater does not have minerals. What you can do best, whenever you are designing, your clients may ask you, okay, are bhai, if the rainwater is good, I am giving the rainwater harvesting tank, please use this for the drinking. You can mix it with normal water and then distribute it for the drinking, but don't directly distribute. Otherwise, put a mineralization plant with the rainwater harvesting storage tank and then distribute it for the drinking. Otherwise, people will have severe issues with their drinking. Sea water. Sea is rich in terms of salt, TDS and TSS also. So we have to remove both. So these are the basic plants, these are the basic water treatment things. Most of the time, 99% time, you need to face RO. Okay, that will help the serve the purpose. And second thing is that RO installing for your clients is okay. Because people bring the normal water in the water bottles, people drink the water at home, at the restaurants, where everywhere they don't get the RO water. So that's not a problem for immunity and telling clients that okay, don't install the RO. For the safety, you must install the RO at such facilities like restaurants, hotels, offices. So, but sometimes if your sources, if your property, if you are designing the property, you use a remote in the place where there is a contamination because of XYZ thing. Like there are bottling plants in the Aurangabad, which are the carbonated water is filled in the bottle. So cleaning, then on the Ullasnagar side you can see so many jeans washing factories are there. They wash the jeans and that chemical is very much hazardous. You might have read. So when you are sourcing such water, you have to take a particular proper treatment process. Only RO might protect. Or there is a rejection in the RO. RO usually rejects 40% of water, even if it is good. So if you get such water, the reject may be 90%. And your RO will be very, very ineffective, inefficient. So any questions, please? Yes, sir. River starts somewhere in the hilly area, like Nasik or interior parts of our country. So there are many cities on those rivers and they throw the water without treating. And the only source you can supply or you can use for a city is river only. The huge quantity of water you can get from river only. So you can get those polluted, no wonder. I mean, looking at current scenario, which hurts me a lot about this jeans washing and chemical throwing in the river. The problem you highlighted, right? But it has no severity, honestly. These are problems are very severe. The source can be anything. Here we talk about 500,000, 2,000, right? There are 30,000, 20,000, 25,000 TDS is there. So you have to filter that out a lot.
Same.
Only that particular portion is added or has given the emphasis. Now, as we spoke, river water, you need basic filtration. If upstream side river is not polluted, on the downstream side, if you are extracting the water, you can just filter and use it. No problem.
Thanks.
Yes.
In general, in Mumbai, BMC or TMC, we need to provide
the. No, not at all. It is the responsibility of the authorities to give you the drinking quality water. If something is happening to you, it is their responsibility to treat you. Okay, so the quality of water is safe. Nobody, I have not seen that, at least not only in Mumbai, I have not seen any municipality which has supplying the water which is contaminated. Okay, it is an extra conscious of a person that okay, I need RO, I need filter. I don't have filter at home, I have that candle filter. Basic, which my grandfather used to use. I don't have any RO, nothing.
But sir, I have a query. Sometimes authority asks for the RO plant or filtration plant in between the fire tank and the domestic tank in between. So what they remark is, as you are using the cold flow water from the fire, yes. So many of the water is getting settled down there. So to continuously have good circulation,
So, if you see the particularly Middle Eastern design, they don't connect it. But they have multiple tanks, fire tanks. Let us say 200 meter cube, they have two tanks of 100 meter cube. But they put a recirculation pump mandatory.
The fire tank.
Yeah. So, now when we design, it is our duty in India to provide this recirculation in such a way that there will not be any stagnation. If you feel at all, my fire tank is 400 meter cube, but my domestic requirement is just 40 meter cube, then you can provide some circulating pumps are nowadays available, which keeps the water whirling inside the tank only. Anything?
We have finished today's all the discussions, technical seminar and presentation from the different companies. So we'll see you back again on 14th of October. Request everyone to be present in full numbers, full majority. Thank you so very much. Thank you so very much.